the time to do anything. Today we're going to talk about the aster, a wonderful late blooming perennial. It is a great food source for late season pollinators, bees that are sticking around, butterflies that are sticking around, ones that are getting ready to move on. And as you can see, it's just a beautiful flower, very delicate looking in the daisy family. And look at that right there. See that little pollinator right there? It's having a good time in there. And it's not just bumblebees, yellow jackets, like this, honeybees, and the like. Sunday for Halloween and for harvest time. Now, asters are, as I said, very important to your late pollinators because there aren't a lot of food sources at this point in time. Flowers such as field fern, chrysanthemums don't produce pollen. That's why asters at this time, which are the other big flower of fall, commercially, I suppose, do produce pollen, and that's why they are loved by pollinators. See right there. Asters come in several different colors, several different varieties. You have this purple color, and then you have a deeper purple, where this bumblebee is having a field day. And over here, you have a sort of a light pink. And in the video, you'll see that there's a darker pink that was at my church. These are New England asters, which are my personal favorite. Now, there's also the asters that you can buy in a pot alongside chrysanthemums at the grocery store or wherever. They're good too. I'm not sure how good they are at naturalizing, but these have spread to different areas. This plant here, as you can see on the end of my driveway, was not planted there, but it took root, so I left it there. And as we come over, this is another variety of aster. It is not in bloom yet. And this has sort of a very light pink to white color, and this is a woodland aster. And then as we go through the garden here to plants that are starting to fade away, here's another aster that took root in a pot. That's another New England aster. And then we have this, which is a very wild aster called a wood aster, and this has a white flower as well. Now, being very important to your late fall garden, mid fall garden, late fall garden, they continuously bloom for probably a month or so, depending on the weather conditions here in New Jersey for the last 2 weeks. Here in September, it has been absolutely gorgeous. Temperatures in the mid-70s, for the most part, nighttime temperatures in the 60s, sometimes in the 50s, depending on where you are. And they don't like a lot of water. They like sun. And they're readily available now. So if I were you, I would go to the garden center right now and get yourself some asters. And as I said, excuse the motorcycle going by, the New England aster is my favorite. And if you pinch these perennials as they are growing into midsummer, they will form more of a mound than these have, but I kind of like the wild look. So anyway, there's your lesson, the aster. My name is Joe Gentile, owner of Plant Health Organics in Frenchtown, New Jersey. Have a great day, everybody, and enjoy fall.